Abu Bakr's question was about taking a child that was born out of wedlock under your own name. So the biological father, though this he is not the legitimate father, if two fornicate and the woman conceives and she gives birth without any marriage, the Islamic ruling is that the child is does not have a father, and he is called after the family of the mother. Why is that? Because of the hadith of the of Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, may Allah be pleased with him, when he disputed with Zum'ah's son. So Saudah bint Zam'ah, may Allah be pleased with her, the mother of the believers, her brother came and claimed that this boy is his brother. Sa'ad came and said, no, this is the son of my brother Utbah. And they disputed and they went to the Prophet ﷺ, and the Prophet acknowledged that the fornication that took place between Utbah and this concubine woman is illegitimate and he gets nothing. And that the child that she conceived due to the fact that she was the concubine of Zum'ah, then he is legitimately considered to be his son because she is his concubine. And he said his famous hadith, الولد للفراش وللعاهر الحجر, which means or translates to that the child belongs to the bed. Who owns the bed? The husband, the master, etc. Then the child belongs to it, and the fornicator gets nothing except a rock or a stone. However, there is some of the scholars who said that when a man claims a child, then this is his name and he has the right and authority to claim him. So if this man claims the child after he was born, but after marrying the mother, not without marriage, so if they got married and then he claimed the son to be, or the child to be his son, some scholars say that this is permissible, and they call it al-istilhaq, when he takes him under his name. And some say that Yazid ibn Abi Sufyan was like that, and it's an issue of dispute whether Abu Sufyan claimed Yazid to be his after that or not, and Allah Azza wa Jalla knows the best.